Hi, so we have started this new instance of our browser, SSH browser. So let first set up Kafka home. So once I am set up Kafka home, we need to start ZooKeeper. Start ZooKeeper. So what is ZooKeeper? So in Kafka, ZooKeeper is used for coordination and managing the cluster state. Like such as keeping track of Kafka brokers, topic, partitions, consumer group information. So everything related to Kafka. So ZooKeeper is responsible for tracking those. So now that we are talking about broker, let's start the Kafka server start script. So this we would be starting one of the broker on Kafka server. So Kafka broker is a server that runs within a Kafka cluster. So Kafka cluster is a group of brokers, and we have started one of the brokers. So brokers are responsible for handling like incoming and outgoing message from producers and consumers. Like they store and replicate Kafka topics, partitions. So they handle all the data replications, distribution across cluster. So these are this is responsibility of a broker. So now that we have created broker, let's see if it is started in the log. So let me check. Yeah, this looks good. No error. Everything is in info. So we have registered broker at zero path. So our broker is started. So now let's go and see how we could create a topic in that broker now. So what is topic? Like topic is a name given to a Kafka to store stream of records or messages. So like it's a core unit topic. So like topics then internally can be now divided into multiple partitions, and then those partitions can be replicated across multiple brokers where like producers can write message to the topics and consumers can read message from the topic. Topic is similar to a table in a database or a folder in a file structure. So where we could store it and multiple people can write to it, multiple people can read from it. So that's what topic is. So in order to create a topic, we can give multiple, pass multiple parameters like create topic. So we can give the topic name. So we are giving first topic as a topic name. Then we have a server name. So we will see how we can give server list here going forward. We can have as many as partitions we have, but as of now we have just one broker. So we have started one partition, but we will see how we can use multiple partitions as well. Similarly for replication factor, we can increase those replication factor. Then we have this cleanup policy. So this cleanup policy is the configuration for this topic only. So this compact policy ensures that topic retains the most recent value for each message key, discarding older values. Similarly, we can give like delete, and we can both give compact and delete as well. So delete will this delete is actually the default cleanup policy. So that based on the retention period specified or retention size specified, older segments that exceeds those retention criteria are removed. Like similarly, if we can use compact and delete together as well. So this should create a topic for us. So yeah, the first topic is created. And what we can do is, so now what as we have created the topic, what we can do is we can also list down what all topics we already we can do is we can list down all the topics which we have. So in order to do that, we can use Kafka topic, and using this list argument, we can see which all topics we have created. So as of now, we have just one topic, first topic. So now that we have some place where we can store our data, let's create a producer. So producer in real world is in like kind of an application or a component so that publishes message to this Kafka topic. So this can be any application, UI, database, anything which generate message. So though this application sends records to a specific topic, so that now we have created this first topic. So our application will send message to this topic that will have a key and a value pair, and it can have like optional timestamp as well. So these applications will publish message So either it can publish message synchronously or in asynchronously, so that depending upon whatever requirements of our data we have, like we can have it both synchronous and asynchronous way as well. So let's see how we can produce. So this could be our sample producer from the command line. So let me. So that our now producer has started. Let me give this. Suppose I am giving the key one colon value one. So this is the format I am giving my key value. Okay, let me remove this. Some extra information. Okay, let me enter. Let me give second message as well. Key two value two. Okay, so the suppose these are the messages which are generated by our applications. Okay, some things to note over here is this acknowledge all. So this sets the acknowledgement configuration to ensure that all the replicas acknowledge this message has been written. So the value all guarantees that message are not considered committed until all replicas have acknowledged them. So similarly, we have now mentioned compression type as well as gzip. So this will ensure that our messages are compression codec is gzip. So this can help to reduce the size of message during transmission. Similarly, we can set like batch size as well. So this allows maximum size of batch of a message before it can be sent to a Kafka broker. Like smaller batches can lead to a lower latency, but potentially like high network overload. So all these properties would be helpful while sending data to a producer. So now that we have sent data to a producer, we have these two messages. So someone should read those messages as well at real time. Okay, so in order to do that, what I need to do is I need to start a consumer. So I would need one more instance of this browser window SSH connect. So that will help me to read that, consume that messages as well. So whatever we were sending. So what I need to do is I need to set up a Kafka home, as we have now again created a new window. We will need to store this export this Kafka home path as well. So once done, yeah, now that our window has started, let's give this, set up this Kafka home. And now that Kafka home is also set up, let me execute the console consumer script. So what this console consumer script will do is it will read first from the topic, first topic from this server, and it will read the message from the beginning. Instead of from beginning, you can give like offset earlier, so that it is similar to from beginning. So but it will instruct the consumer to start consuming from the earliest offset available in that topic. Similarly, you can give that offset number as well. So we will see what those offsets are, like offset. It allows you to specify offset from where the consumer should start reading the message. Basically, each message will have its own offset in each partitions. And similarly, max message is this important property. So suppose, for example, if producers are stopped for a period, like your application is stopped for a period, and when it is restarted, they might generate a large number of message in short period of time. Okay, so by setting this max message to a specific value, you can limit the number of message the consumer will process. So this will help preventing overwhelming the consumer with potentially large backlog of a message. So this typically is useful when you are like either testing or want to make sure that your application, even if the consumer producer is stopped for some time, and your consumer should not get bottlenecked with lot of messages. So this will help you in that. So when I press enter here, so it should now read the message. So it has read this key value, key and the value. Okay, so let me go back here and give one more like key three colon value three, and let's see. It's coming. So this is what happens in real time when we are generating message from producer, and our consumer is able to read it. So now let's see what we can, how we can use external websites or to generate data, and then we can use like Databricks to process them and store them. So let's see, and we also will see how we can use multiple brokers. So right now we are using just a single broker. So let's see how we can use multiple partitions and multiple brokers.